I first met Robert Mugabe in the southern town of Mbeya, of Tanzania, Mbeya, in 1962. We had a meeting of PAFMESCA that was held in Mbeya. I was very much impressed by the statement and his contribution to that conference. He was coming from Ghana, where he was teaching at the time. Now, later on, I met Mugabe during the struggle in many different occasions. We met in Tanzania, we met in Zambia, where we had the offices. ZANU-PF had an office there. We had an office there. And we used to interact, especially when issues concerning the total liberation of Southern Africa. Robert Mugabe was a leader who led the people of Zimbabwe after independence, who defied the continuation of the British establishment in Zimbabwe. At the negotiation of the independence of Zimbabwe in London, the British made some commitments which Zimbabwe should adhere to for a certain period of time after independence. When the British failed to meet the commitment that they made at the negotiation for independence of Zimbabwe, the time came when Robert Mugabe decided to take the land. The commitment, by the way, was that the British would give money for the Zimbabwe government to buy land from the white British subject, not only the subject of Britain, but also South Africans who were owning the land in Zimbabwe. When the British failed, Zimbabwe took action to take over some lands from the whites, a situation that angered Britain and the Western world, Americans included. And the Western world, on the persuasion of the British, together with the British, decided to impose sanctions in Zimbabwe. Robert said, and I'm not quoting him, he is going to take the land of Zimbabwe and give it to the Zimbabweans. Doesn't matter how painful it would be when sanctions were imposed. Zimbabwe assisted SWAPO, Zimbabwe under Robert Mugabe. I recall on the 1st of April 1989, ZANU-PF invited the leadership of SWAPO to go and have discussions in the form of a seminar. Our delegation was led by Comrade Sam Nujoma, then the president of SWAPO. It was a group of people from the leadership of SWAPO. They were telling us how to run the government. They were telling us how they took actions in favor of the people of Zimbabwe, obviously not in favor of the British and the others who had imposed the sanctions against the country. So it was in Zimbabwe on the 1st of April when it happened here, I think you can recall.
Yes.
We were there when April the 1st started in 1989. Mm. It found us in Zimbabwe. The current president of the Republic of Namibia, who was the director of the Institute for Namibia in Lusaka, joined us in Zimbabwe. So SWAPO benefited a lot on the Zimbabwe government. I recall at that time the whole country was asked to make a contribution to SWAPO. And money was donated and other materials were donated to SWAPO at that particular time. It was a Namibia week in Zimbabwe. We were taken around the country. Robert Mugabe was an African leader, an able leader at that. And again, I express, and before I say again, I express, when I was in the office as head of state, Mugabe visited this country on my invitation. That was not the first time. Obviously, when Sam Nujoma was the head of state, Mugabe visited this country. That's why today you have one of the longest street in Windhoek called Mugabe. It was named at that time when Mugabe first came to Namibia or to Windhoek on the invitation of Comrade Sam Nujoma. As I was coming to the office this afternoon, and I always do. I came along the Robert Mugabe Road and I kept on thinking about Robert. Robert, I think the last time I met Robert is when we went to the independence celebration. Sam Nujoma was in the delegation. I was in the delegation. We paid a cutter's call, that is President Nujoma, Vice President Nicky Yambo, and myself at Robert Mugabe's private residence in Harare. We had very good discussions. Of course, that was just at the time when he was removed from the office. We felt that we should not leave Zimbabwe without having seen our comrade Robert Mugabe, and we did. So this is what briefly I can say about Robert Mugabe. To me, Robert Mugabe was a colleague. To me, Robert Mugabe was a trusted brother. He's a trusted brother, and I gained a lot from Robert Mugabe at the time when I was a freedom fighter, at the time when I was a minister after independence of this country, when I visited Zimbabwe, and when I became the president for 10 years working together with Comrade Robert Mugabe. His soul rest in eternal peace. That is all what I can say about Robert Mugabe.